Hello students, this is Shweta Roy. This video is for Chapter 2, Part 3, Geography, Physical Features of India. In this video, we are going to discuss about the question answers of the chapter. So first we have question 1. Choose the right answer from the four alternatives given below. First is, a landmass bounded by sea on three sides is referred to as, and the answer is peninsula. Second, mountain ranges in the eastern part of India forming its boundary with Myanmar are collectively called as, the answer is Purvachal. Third, the western coastal strip south of Goa is referred to as, answer is B, Kannur. Fourth, the highest peak in the Eastern Ghats is, the answer is Mahendragiri. Next question 2. Answer the following questions briefly. And first is, what are tectonic plates? The answer is, due to internal heat of the earth, the currents of the semi-molten rocks begin to move towards the crust and tear it apart, dividing it into large fragments called lithospheric or tectonic plates. There are seven such major plates, namely South America, North America, Pacific, Indo-Australian, Eurasian, African, and Antarctic. Second question, which continents of today were parts of the Gondwana land? Answer is, Gondwana land is the name given to the hypothetical supercontinent located in southern hemisphere. Gondwana land included South America, part of Africa, South Africa including Madagascar, part of Asia, India, Arabia, Malaya, Australia and Antarctica. Prior to its breakup under the forces causing continental drift, what is Bhabar? Answer is, the Bhabar is that narrow belt of the plain which is covered with pebbles and lies along the foothills of the Shivaliks from the Indus to the Tista. This belt is laid down by numerous streams descending down the hills. Next question, name the three major divisions of the Himalayas from north to south. एंड आंसर इज द थ्री मेजर डिविजन्स ऑफ द हिमालयाज फ्रॉम नॉर्थ टू साउथ आर द नॉर्दर्न मोस्ट रेंज विच इज नोन एज द ग्रेट हिमालयाज और इनर हिमालयाज और द हिमाद्री. सेकेंड द रेंज लाइंग टू द साउथ ऑफ द हिमाद्री विच इज नोन एज हिमाचल और द लेसर हिमालय. थर्ड द आउटर मोस्ट रेंज ऑफ द हिमालयाज विच इज नोन एज द शिवालिक्स. दीज आर द फुटिल ranges and represent the southernmost division of the Himalayas. Question number 5. Which plateau lies between the Aravali and the Vindhyan ranges? The answer is Malwa plateau or Central Highlands. Next question. Name the island group of India having coral origin. And the answer is Lakshadweep. Question 3. Distinguish between. First is converging and diverging tectonic plates. The answer is the internal heat of the earth makes the molten rocks to rush towards the surface of the earth and drive the crust into large fragments known as tectonic plates. These plates are drifting over the mantle of the earth. As a result, when the two or more plates are pushed towards each other, they are called converging plates. On the other hand, if they are moving away from each other, they are called diverging plates. Next question, Bangar and Khadar. According to the age of the soils of the northern plain, they have been differentiated by two names, Bangar and Khadar. The difference between these two are mentioned below. First, Bhangar. These are the older alluvium or old soil and form the largest part of the northern plains. They lie above the flood plains of the rivers and present a terrace-like structure. It often contains conker nodules made of calcareous deposits. Second is Khadar. The newer and younger deposits of the floodplains are known as Khadar. So, these are the new alluvium or new soil and are very fertile. Thus, Khadar is ideal for intensive agriculture. Third is Western Ghats and Eastern Ghats. The Western Ghats are situated and mark the western edge of Deccan Plateau parallel to the western coasts of India along the Arabian Sea. Whereas The Eastern Ghats are situated and mark the eastern edges of Deccan Plateau, parallel to the eastern coasts of India along the Bay of Bengal. Second, continuous can be crossed through the passes only. Discontinuous, irregular and dissected by rivers draining into the Bay of Bengal. Third, the Western Ghats are higher than the Eastern Ghats. Average elevation is 900 to 1600 meters, whereas average elevation of Eastern Ghat is 600 meters. Fourth, the height increases progressively from north to south. The highest peaks include the Anai Mudi, the Doda Belt. Whereas the highest peaks of Eastern Ghat include the Mahendragiri, the Jawadi Hills. Fifth, the Western Ghats enclose a narrow strip between its western slopes and the Arabian Sea, which is known as Western Coastal Plain. Its maximum width is 64 km, whereas the Eastern Ghats also enclose a strip of land between its eastern slopes and the Bay of Bengal, which is known as the Eastern Coastal Plain. It is wider than the Western Coastal Strip, with its maximum breadth 120 km. 6. It experiences orographic rain mostly in summer due to the summer monsoons. The climate is hot and moist, whereas in Eastern Ghats it receives rain both in summer and winter, especially in winter through winter monsoons. However, here the rain is lesser than the Western Strip. 7. Here the soil is highly fertile. Rice, spices, rubber and fruits like coconuts, cashew nuts, etc. are grown here. Whereas in Eastern Ghats, the soil is not as fertile as Western Strip. Rice, groundnut, cotton, tobacco, coconuts, etc. are grown here. 4. Describe how the Himalayas were formed. And the answer is, the Indian Peninsula drifted towards the north and finally collided with the much larger Eurasian plate. As a result of this collision, the sedimentary rocks which were accumulated in the geosynclines known as tethys got folded and formed the mountain systems of the West Asia and Himalaya. Question number 5. Which are the major physiographic divisions of India? Contrast the relief relief of the Himalayan region with that of the peninsular plateau? The answer is, the major physiographic divisions of India are the following. First, the Himalayan mountain wall of the north. B, the northern plains. C, the peninsular plateau. D, the Indian desert. E, the coastal plains. F, the islands. The following table compares and contrasts between the relief of the Himalayan region with that of the peninsular plateau. First, the Himalayas are young fold mountains of comparatively recent origin, whereas peninsular plateau, they are a part of the oldest structures of the Indian subcontinent. Second, they are the highest mountains in the world, whereas the central highlands are formed of low hills and there is no high peak of worldwide fame in these hills. Third, many great rivers like the Indus, the Ganges and the Brahmaputra originate from the Himalayas, whereas very few rivers like the Narmada and the Tapti originate from these hills. Fourth number, the Himalayas are formed of the sedimentary rocks, whereas the central highlands are formed of igneous and metamorphic rocks. Fifth, they are formed at the edge of the Indo-Gangetic plain, whereas peninsular plateaus are formed at the edge of the Deccan Plateau. Sixth, important hill stations like Shimla, Mussoorie, Darjeeling, Nainital are found on the Himalayas, whereas no well-known hill station is found here. Number 6, give an account of the northern plains of India. The answer is, the great northern plain extends from the Punjab plain in the west to the Brahmaputra valley in the east. The northern plain has been formed by the interplay of the three major river systems, namely the Indus, the Ganga and the Brahmaputra along with it with their tributaries. The deposition of alluvium in a vast basin lying at the foothills to the south of the Himalayas over millions of years formed this fertile plain. It spreads over an area of 7 lakh square kilometers. The plain is about 2,400 kilometer long and 240 to 320 kilometer broad. The rich soil cover combined with the abundant water supply and favorable climate made this agriculturally a very productive part of India. Because of this factor, the density of population is also the highest in this region among all the physiographic divisions of India. The northern plain is broadly divided into three sections. First, the Punjab plain. It is the western part of northern plain, formed by the Indus and its tributaries. This section is dominated by the Doabs. B. The Ganga Plain. It is the largest part of the northern plain and extends between Ghaggar and Tista rivers. C. The Brahmaputra Plain. It forms the eastern part of the northern plain by the river Brahmaputra and its tributaries. It is narrower than the Ganga Plain and it is a flood-prone area. In the southeast side of the northern plain lays the Ganga-Brahmaputra Delta, which is the largest delta of the world. Now we have write short notes on the following. First is the Indian desert. The answer is, lying towards the west of the Aravali Hills, the Indian desert is an undulating sandy plain covered with crescent shaped and longitudinal sand dunes. This region is characterized by very little rainfall, an arid climate and low vegetation cover. Streams appear only during the rainy season. Luni is the only large river in this region. Second, the central highlands. Answer is, the part of the peninsular plateau lying to the north of the Narmada River, covering a major area of the Malwa Plateau, is known as the Central Highlands. They are bound by the Vindhya Range from south and by the Aravali Hills from the northwest. The further westward extension merges with the Indian Desert, while the eastward extension is marked with the Chotanagpur Plateau. The rivers draining this region flow from southwest to northwest. The central highlands are wider in the west but narrower in the east. Third is the island groups of India. The answer is, India has two groups of islands. The Lakshadweep Islands lies in the Arabian Sea to the southwest of the mainland. The Andaman and Nicobar Islands lie in the Bay of Bengal to the southeast of the mainland. Lakshadweep is composed of small coral islands covering a small area of 32 square kilometers. Kavarathi Island is its administrative headquarters. The Andaman and Nicobar Islands are bigger in size and are more numerous and scattered. The entire group of islands is divided into Andaman in the north and Nicobar in the south. Both these island groups are rich in flora and fauna and are of great strategic importance to the country. Here we have an activity. Locate the peaks, passes, ranges, plateaus, hills and dunes hidden in the puzzle. Try to find where these features are located. You may start your search horizontally, vertically and diagonally. So here you have answer of this. I hope you all understood all the topics taught in this video. Thank you.